What's going on YouTube, Roman Ads here. Welcome back to my Red Dead Redemption 2 walkthrough. Let's get straight into it. I'm almost at the main mission, which is just around the corner from here. I'm still gutted that my horse died. I love that horse. Funniest thing is that this horse is now. I've got now. It's a boy, but I've called it Megan.
Hey, do I know you?
Mr. I believe we've met.
We have.
At that ghastly party.
Oh, Evelyn Miller.
Unfortunately so, Mr.
Arthur Morgan, at least sometimes.
Can I say something rude?
Sure.
The mayor thinks you robbed him. Well, to be clear, he wasn't very upset about it. He rather liked you.
Okay.
Do you, can you steal things?
Is there a reason you're asking me to incriminate myself, Mr. Miller?
Well, I'm sorry. Have you met? This is Rainsfall, the great chief, and his son, Eagle Flags.
Gentlemen, we saw you in the wagon train crossing the river at Cumberland Falls. And at the party, you were upstairs.
You have great powers of observation.
It's my people, if we are even a people anymore. We've fought hard. We've made peace treaties, and those treaties were broken, and we've been moved and punished and moved.
I'm sure.
And now I am told we are to be moved again.
Clearly contravening the peace treaty signed 3 years ago.
This will lead to war.
No, my son, it will not. We cannot fight another war. They have got stronger, and we have become far weaker, Mr. Morgan.
It's a bad business.
It's to do with oil. I know it is, but I need the proof. I believe there were some prospectors who were on their land a few months ago who have filed reports with Leviticus Cornwall and the state government claiming huge reserves of oil under their land.
So, you want me to try and steal it?
Obviously they can't. And even more obviously, I would be useless. Listen, I realize that it is a ridiculous request, but we're very desperate.
Now, I'm not a do-gooder, Mr. Miller. Gentlemen, I'm very sorry for your predicament, but I'm a working man. I got problems of my own.
We will pay you very handsomely, Mr. Morgan.
I think I mentioned Morgan, and he's like...
They're all mercenaries.
There's a price on my head in two states, my friend. The government doesn't like me any more than it does you. Like you, I've been running for as long as I can remember. And like you, my time here is nigh undone.
We understand, and we will pay.
Thank you.
You meet my son in a couple of days near Citadel Rock, just west of the oil fields.
Okay.
We are very grateful for your help.
Gentlemen, an appointment with the senator. We should head over there.
It's a waste of our time. And his.
We must try everything. Come along.
I got a feeling that the dad's gonna die at some point.
Hello, Mr. Miller. The counselor wants to apologize. He can see you now.
We've been waiting I don't know how long.
Or next month, if you'd like to reschedule.
Come. Perhaps the senator won't mind waiting.
Yeah. I'll walk in here. I'm actually going there as well.
Oh, shit. You got a big chip on your shoulder, huh?
Okay there.
Yeah. Alright. So, which mission do I do now? I'll probably do the one that's just up the road, just there. Whoa, where's the other mission then? Oh. That's Sandy? Yeah. Oh, she's crazy. She's funny, man. Alright, so, yeah, just sort of turn around and start that one there. I'll do a white question mark first.
Okay, boy.
Before I do that main mission. Just because it's only around the corner, so. Yeah!
What exactly is the issue at hand?
Excuse me, sir. Can I bother you for a minute of your time?
Yeah, why not?
All right. Nice to see you again, sir. Did you change your mind about donating by any chance? We could really use your support to improve the lives of our veterans and their families.
I wish I could donate, but I don't have the money. I'm actually broke right now.
You have a nice day.
What I get for upgrading all my guns and getting arrested a few times. Oh, and getting killed.
Morning.
I bet it did.
Ah, there you are, dear boy.
Yes, here I am.
Well, we're going to need to get you smartened up a bit.
Why?
Well, you can't play at the tables on a Lanahassee riverboat looking like this.
Yeah?
Not if you want to fit in so well that no one will realize you're there to rob the place. Now, come on.
Are we still doing that?
Of course. We're going to fix you up so fine no one will notice a thing.
Okay. So, I just want to get a bottle of water real quick.
Hello. Can I help you, gentlemen?
Yes, my friend here is in need of a new suit. We are playing on the riverboat this evening.
Excellent. Well, you'll find all my inventory in the catalog here.
I've only got paper because I've only got like $3.
It was the English's fault his grandfather had to emigrate. A bitter and jealous people.
You know, I can't like that, actually.
Come on, let's get you to the barber.
Sure.
Good luck tonight, gentlemen.
Hope you're paying, because I ain't.
Herr Strauss has scoped the whole thing out. It's quite ingenious, actually.
Where's my horse?
What is?
The action he has planned. Indeed, it's not much of an action at all. You play cards and win, and you're going to bet very big and flamboyantly while you win. And everyone's going to think you're some new money from the oil fields come to lay it on thick and drunk. All the while, Herr Strauss will be signaling you in your line of sight. When you bust the place, they'll take you upstairs to pay you off. And that
is
when Javier comes in, and you take whatever you want.
You don't think they might see an armed Mexican coming into the safe with me?
Sure, they might, but perhaps not. You will see.
The suspense is killing me.
Oh, don't be so jaded. We both know this is just the kind of innocent fun you thrive on.
Well, after the past couple of months, armed robbery don't seem such an innocent pastime.
No, but all of us will be done here soon.
I hope so.
Come on. My good man, could you smarten up my dear hick friend here? This unlikely fellow has made himself a fortune in the oil fields. And learned himself not a lick of manners or gentlemanly deportment.
Well, very good, sir.
No, it's not good. Not good at all. Not if they're going to let him play big at the tables tonight.
Whoa, bold. Man, it's scary like that. Just like that, then. That kind of suits me, facial hair like that as well. Facial hair.
Make him look like a prince, sir.
Thank you. Can I see some, actually?
Very smart.
Come on, let's get to the docks.
I've arranged some transportation for us.
This place sure is something else. And it ain't good.
This is a very
George! To the Grand Corrigan, please.
Grand Corrigan, sir.
Well, look at you! From Toad to Prince.
Yeah, this is a bit much, ain't it? The coach?
We can't winny up there on horses like a bunch of countrified yokels. You're a brash oil man. Money to burn. Which reminds me, no shuffling and mumbling. Puff your chest out. Get outside yourself.
Yeah, all right, all right. Saint Hammy. So, who's a mark? Are you all right, by the way, the driver?
Oh, yes. Don't worry. George and I go way back. It's a man called Desmond Blythe. Made a fortune in hosiery, of all things. Likes to play fast and always keep some extra collateral in the safe upstairs.
So, if Strauss is sitting behind him, how does he know what cards I got?
He won't. But the dealer has recently become a very good friend of mine.
Another one.
Don't worry, Arthur. We're all the authors of our own good fortune. He'll make sure you get the right cards.
What could possibly go wrong?
Indeed.
And what money am I playing with?
Don't worry. That has all been arranged. Your chips will be waiting for you.
Ah, there she is. Come on.
Okay.
I'm hoping to poker. I don't play that myself.
They'll search us when we get on. George? We'll collect these from you later.
Very good, sir.
Thank you, George.
Good luck, sir.
Now remember what I said, Arthur. Everyone is the author of his own good fortune.
Yes, yes. Believe me, I heard every word.
Watch a second, guys.
Listen to the dealer, and this should be a very lucky night.
Gentlemen, how wonderful to see you. Arthur, you remember this pair of boys we met in New York?
Come on.
Champagne is on dear old Arthur. He's rich as can be and feeling luckier than a turkey that survived Thanksgiving.
Hello, gentlemen.
Hello, dear boy. Come on, come on, let's head aboard. Drinks on Arthur. Champagne.
I'm afraid we require all patrons to hand over their guns.
Good time. The tables await.
I'll go find myself a change of clothes.
Okay.
You seem unsure.
Robbing a heavily armed riverboat without a gun tends to bring out the self-doubt in me.
These people are virtually idiots. This is simple stuff. Now have a good time.
Yeah, simple.
But don't lose too much money or your wife is going to kill me.
Whatever you say.
Now, where can I get a cocktail?
Take a seat, sir.
I'm hoping to poke off. I hope I ain't got to play. I am absolutely hopeless.
Good evening, gentlemen. Arthur Callahan. Sorry I'm late. I had some unfinished business at the bar.
Hey, Desmond Blythe.
Evening.
Not to worry. Welcome to the game, Mr. Callahan. Okay, gentlemen. Let's play.
I hope you're a player. Been too many cowards at these tables recently. Nothing less dignified than a man afraid to lose a little money.
Look at this! Chips already stacked up waiting for me. I like this joint already.
We aim to please, sir.
So, how are we all faring?
Some better than others.
If we all fared the same in life now, where would the fun be?
Quiet.
Wait, not Desmond Blythe, the hosiery king. I should have brought my other wallet.
Not my preferred title, but yes, you should have.
Here we go, then. Hello, my ladies.
Mr. Blythe wins with three queens.
Goodbye, gentlemen. I guess it's just you and me now, off. Friend.
Yes, it is.
Time to see if you're really the man you seem to think you are.
Likewise, Mr. Blythe.
So, what business are you in, Mr. Callahan?
I'm an oil man, for my sins.
Funny. I haven't heard of you.
Oh, you will. You know, I thought about getting into hosiery, but I just look better in a suit.
I would stick to oil, Mr. Callahan. I don't think you have a future on the stage.
You sound just like my wife.
Sorry to do this to you, but I have no choice. All in.
Now what the hell? It's only money. Interesting. Pair of cowgirls.
Shit. Shit. I won.
I guess my luck held. Is that you done?
Done?
Bust. Or, you got something else to play with.
Meaning?
I heard there were some big boys on this boat. Maybe that's not you. No offense.
Sit your hillbilly ass down.
Why?
I got a watch.
Look at you.
An expensive one. Real fine. Swiss. A Reutlinger, no less. It's in the safe upstairs. It's worth more than you.
Okay. I trust you.
Now play.
As you wish.
So, you must know Leviticus Cornwall, big oil man like you.
Of course, we've crossed paths. I was fortunate enough to tour a little operation heads up in New Hanover.
Two kings.
Let's not waste any more time here. All in.
Don't worry, sir. Everyone is the author of his own good fortune.
All in, okay.
Well, nothing ventured, nothing gained. Pair of kings.
Very good, but not good enough.
Ace of spades, kings.
Shit. Uh-oh. Yes, you little beauty.
Hard lines, Mr. Blythe. Mr. Callahan wins with an ace high diamond flush.
God damn you!
No offense.
None taken.
Well played, sir.
Unlucky, Desmond.
Now, forgive my lack of discretion, but where might I find this watch?
It's upstairs. Shall we go and have a look?
Why not?
Gentlemen,
please, cash these out for me.
I started last week.
Good. Sure.
Javier.
Perhaps you could escort us up to the office.
Yes, of course, sir.
Thank you.
Follow me, gentlemen.
Come with me, sir. You're having quite the night.
Yeah, so far.
I cannot believe someone gave a greaser a job.
We live in strange times.
Personally, I wouldn't trust one with a gun, but fear not. I've got my own little lawgiver right here.
Very good.
Oh, so you can have guns on the boat, but we can't.
We'll be hiring Negroes.
Yeah, I know.
I think you're going to like this watch, sir. I saw it earlier, and it really is a handsome piece. Foreign made, but you can't have everything.
Indeed.
Well, here we are. Just give me one second, sir.
Of course, take your time. Don't reach for that gun.
Take his gun, Arthur.
Guess you were right. Only an idiot would give a greaser a gun. Idiot, huh?
Why would you try that?
You in here is looking pretty good.
How much is there?
Must be a few thousand plus the watch.
Nice. Now let's get out of here. Come on. Let's go meet the other ship.
Sure.
I reckon we've only got a few minutes to get out of here.
If we're lucky.
Is that a gunshot?
It sounded like one. Come on.
And how exactly are we getting out of here?
I ain't too sure. This is what tends to happen when you leave Trelawney in charge of planning. Won't garnish no meat. Probably involve us dressing up as dancing girls and can-canning off the side. Nice uniform, by the way.
Thanks. I'd give anyone a job these days. Anyway, we shouldn't give ourselves away till we know we need to. Maybe we could still blend into the crowd when it all goes crazy.
Which it surely will. To the bar, senor!
I hope you had fun, sir.
At the time of my life. You boys sure know how to put on a show.
It's wonderful. Ah, look, there's your friend.
No, sir, my friend is not a noble chief, and I beg you to take back the insinuation.
There he is.
Now, don't be a sore loser, friend.
There's something I don't like about the pair of you.
There's plenty I don't like about you, but I have the good manners to keep my mouth shut.
There he is. Shoot that man.
You shoot someone, Javier. So they let me do all the shooting. I'm getting shot from all different directions, and you're just standing there like a lemon. Please help me.
Come on, let's get the hell out of here.
I killed most of them men there myself.
I don't.
I ain't got swimming that way myself in. It took ages.
Well, never a dull moment.
Yeah, that's one way of putting it.
So, how much did we get?
A few thousand, I think. Pretty good.
Yes, indeed.
And this watch, apparently it's worth a bunch. Swiss, a Reutlinger or something?
Nice watch. Yes, it's a Reutlinger, all right.
Don't get stinging, man.
All right, come on, let's get out of here.
Looks like I'll probably sting it himself. Nice. Got my money back then.
Good morning.
Right, where to now? Yeah, I was gonna go there, wasn't I? Because I'd done it all the way. Must have donated the money. It's like, I'm just. Like, I ain't got no money, mate. You idiot. Yeah, why not?
Nice to see you again, sir.
Come on, get clear.
Did you change your mind about donating by any chance? We could really use your support to improve the lives of our veterans and their families.
There you go.
$20 ain't no chicken feed, but sure, I can help you out.
That's very kind. What is your name, sir?
Arthur Morgan.
Your donation will be acknowledged
on the
founder's plaque when the building is completed.
Want to.
You have a great day, Mr. Morgan.
Hello. How are you today?
Let me through.
That done? Right, where to now then? Ooh, let's check that one here. I barely even hit that one then. Look, still that thing. I don't even see who I was. Right, who am I meant to see in here? One of these?
Hey, move!
Oh, well.
Oh, in here. Okay.
This is extremely delicate.
Hey.
There. Wonderful. Algernon Wasp, purveyor of the exotic and the exquisite. Enchanté.
Tacitus Kilgore.
How can I help you? May I interest you in a hat, perhaps? How about a nymph? I import them from Brussels. The idiots in this town all want Italian nymphs, but the Italians make the coarsest of marble. I mean, quite frankly, the Baroque is an abomination. Belgium. Now that is a land for the connoisseur.
Oh, yes. Yeah, as I always say. But, you know, I'm not really a nymph kind of man.
No, of course, too ephemeral. You want something, more tangible, more gothic. I also make corsets. Would you like a corset? I always wear one.
No. I don't think so. Yeah, I ride a lot of horses, and the whalebone might stick in.
Well, a cup of tea.
Sure.
And what is it you do, Mr. Kilgore? Are you a gentleman of leisure? An aesthete? An artist.
I suppose I'm kind of an adventurer.
Ha! Yes, of course you are. Here, be careful with the china, sir. It is French.
Not Belgian?
No. They are Philistines in that area, not to be trusted. Youth, eternally preserved in marble, is more their specialty. I fear China will always elude them. Now, why are you here exactly?
I don't know.
You're an adventurer. A wanderer, a lost soul cast out from heaven?
Sure.
Well, I do pay exceptionally well for certain objects needed for my art.
You do?
I do. Exceptionally well.
Well, what do you need?
Let's see. Right now, I have a couple of commissions. I need at least 15 egret plumes. Good ones, obviously. I also need 15 assorted orchids. Here's a list.
Okay. I'll see what I can do. Thanks for the tea.
Thank you, Tacitus. It'll be very worth your while.
Okay, that's almost done. That's quite quick. Right. Now, where's the closest mission? You know, I'm gonna head to shot, but head most of it. It's not that far, so I'll start recording again when I get there, guys. Okay, give me a sec. Hey, what's going on over here? I was meant to do there, but okay. Oh, the one raiders, I'm not marking them. And I thought I killed them all. You don't see. You know, over there.
Alright, boy. Yep.
How much farther for this mission? Oh, I'm just getting here. I think this is the robbery one, isn't it? From Moonshine. Yeah.
Where's this shine? Okay, then.
Right on time.
Who we got here?
Bounty guards. easy. So far. I don't want to jinx it.
That's not alright. Let's get you home.
As well. Okay. I'm not sure you're paying for it. Pretty sure I can fetch a bit of money if I sold it myself. Gang anyway.
So, I got your moonshot!
You're a wonderful man! Wonderful!
My money?
It's for a very good cause. My name is Professor Andrew Bell III. Perhaps you've heard of me.
Can't say that I have.
Well, I'm an inventor. Maybe you've read about me.
I don't read much.
Oh, well, that's too bad. Oh, yes.
You got my money?
Well, it is the most wonderful invention, friend. Oh, you, sir, have done a great deal.
All I've done is get some creep a lot of drinks.
Creepers? Excellent. Nonsense. Now, you've helped me develop the most humane machine imaginable. A way to induce calmness to our most troubled souls. A way to end the barbarity of a public hanging. Oh, so, so humane.
What are you talking about?
The electric chair.
What?
It's a chair full of electricity. Quite fascinating. It calmly and peacefully dispatches the sinners to face judgment. Yes, judgment.
Where is it?
Well, it's in my laboratory. The next thing I need is a demonstration. A public one. Huh. Do you know the police chief?
As well as anyone.
Oh, wonderful! Perhaps you can encourage him to let me demonstrate the chair. It will help bring this town into the next century. Yes, could you do that?
I guess so. Alright.
Out of the damn way!
Map. Oh, that's only there. Stagecoach up there or something. Takes quite a while to go there. Like 5 minutes, 10 minutes. Right, see you in the next part, guys. I'll see you in a sec. Alright, while I'm here.
So, welcome to our humble police house.
Oh, can I go through here?
Can I help you with something? Chief, I'm representing the inventor of a humane execution machine. An electric chair. And he, wants to demonstrate his invention here.
Ah, I'm familiar with the man and his work. Tell you what, I'll give you a permit. But it's gonna cost you $100 in fees.
No, no, I don't mind. Okay, done.
Okay, well, price is fair. Here you go.
And here, sir, is your permit. Pending the usual formalities, of course, such as finding a suitable candidate for humane dispatching.
I'll tell that to the professor.
Good luck.
Let's quickly return back to the professor. Get that out of the way. It's underwear anyway. Okay, done completely then.
Okay, boy.
Assuming they get there, guys. I'm here.
Friend.
Hello, Professor...
Andrew Bell the Third.
That's it. So, the chief says you can test out your machine, and in the usual formalities.
And what are they?
Finding a suitable, subject.
Ah, funny you should mention. This fella here, he seems sturdy enough, and he's guilty of sin.
Wilson J. McDaniel, wanted for murder, bigamy, and... immoral animal husbandry. What's that?
Mine shudders. Here, find him for me.
Oh,
be put him out of his misery.
Come on, Captain. Okay. How far is that? I ain't going all the way up there just for that. Not yet, at least. Okay, let's go down to Slady then. Right, I'll see you when I get back to camp, guys. Give me a sec. I'm just getting back to camp now.
Arthur! Do you hear me? Look what the guys are after
you. Easy there.
Right. What's that target thing over there? Hello.
It's a nice place you brought us to, my brother.
Yes. Lovely, isn't it?
Yeah. Makes me miss freezing to death in the mountains.
Yeah. Okay, well, let's talk more later.
Okay, then.
How you doing, Mr. Zedler?
How are you? Been quite a journey since I joined you fellas. And now you and Dutch have joined high society. Oh, Lord above.
Yeah, it seems so.
I think my days in polite society are over.
Well, I just saw Bill Williamson at a party at the San Denise mayor's house. If he can do it, anyone can.
You get any leads?
Yeah, I think so.
You know so, Arthur Morgan. Come on, we need to talk. Miss Adler, will you excuse us?
When are you gonna let me come robbing with you, Dutch?
My lord, a few more like her, we could take over the whole world.
A few more like her, there wouldn't be much of a world left.
Yes, perhaps. Now, the trolley bus station. I went down there. I took a look at it. I think we can hit it.
I ain't never robbed in a city before.
Well, you leave the planning to me. You'll ride with me.
Always. Is it just you and me?
No, we'll need one more, I reckon.
I say Lenny.
Yeah, I've been saying Lenny myself.
That depends if you want a massacre or a payday.
No, I wish that there was something I could do to make the two of you get along better.
Well, that's easy. Make him change.
Very funny. What is that?
What the hell?
Everybody take cover! Or Crystal Boys are coming!
know where we are now. We're gonna have to move soon. Hold it. Guess not. Would have, if they didn't actually leave when they did, we kept fighting and holding it, we might have actually done it. No point retreating. Just gonna trap ourselves. What a fun mission though. Oh, I missed that.
Get behind us, Wagon! We're getting over well! Fall back to the house!
What the hell?
Might just be a clatter over there. Maybe not. Doing. plus one, don't they?
Mr. Swanson, could you take this boy and bury him someplace near, but not too near?
Of course. Charles, help me with the body.
We need to get this place cleaned up. Mr. Pearson, Miss Grimshaw.
Already taking care of it. Come on now, work.
Colm O'Driscoll. That man can really.
Imagine just carrying that man's head like that.
So can I, Arthur. So can I. We need to get moving. Away from here.
So we should start looking for another camp.
You ain't thinking big enough, Arthur. You ain't seeing the vastness of our problems and our opportunities.
I'm not sure I get you.
You will, son. You will. Meet me near the trolley station. We got work.
Shall we?
Yep.
Have fun.
Spared from O'Driscoll's gang up in the mountains is dead. They chopped his head off and tried to kill the lot of us. Whole place giving me the creeps.
Alright. Safe to say we survived that one then. Where's the nearest mission? Give me a second, guys, just do something on my phone real quick. Alright. Map. Dutch is all the way in there.
Clean up.
In every sense. This has all gotten a little crazy.
We need to find where those O'Driscolls are at and go hit them back.
I agree.
Yep. Easy now.
Poor horse. That might be me. Where did that horse come from? Give me a sec, guys, I'll start recording when I get there. Like I usually do. Getting here, so I'm guessing down this alley. No thanks.
There you are. Come on, keep walking. You're late.
Well, tasing this place, you turned into some clock watching city boy. What's the urgency?
We need to leave. Forever.
We've been doing well, making money. But for us all to leave together, we need enough for a boat. Now, I found a friendly ship captain. He's willing to take us to Australia or Tahiti. We just need to pay for passage and give him money for land when we get there. No questions asked. We will disappear. Be reborn.
Well, where the hell is Tahiti?
South Pacific. An untouched paradise.
Who lives there?
Tahitians, I guess.
We made a bit of money on that riverboat job, but not enough for us to leave and live peacefully. Where's the rest coming from?
In there.
So we are gonna rob that place.
Well, I didn't think we was fixing the plumbing. I don't know if you have noticed, but we are on the clock. I reckon we got a few days.
Gonna get us killed, Dutch.
And showing then, look, we're done. Now we need money. Bronte said this place has got money. Come on.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is a robbery. Behave as I tell you, and none of you will die. Annoy me, and you all will. Now remember, we just
you need to give
money.
Me all your money.
Don't make
now.
Us kill you.
Please!
Fine folks are their valuables. Mr. S, check that room back there. I got this one. Fine.
Now, I'm gonna need everything you got on.
Okay. Fine, it's yours.
Let my clean skin side.
I said open the gate.
Okay.
Let my clean
everything you got. Quick.
Yes. Of course.
Just take it.
There's nothing much here.
What?
There's nothing really here.
You're sure?
Yes.
Now don't make any dumb moves.
And get ready for company.
I'm ready to.
Behave. We don't want to hurt any of you. Mr. M, check the safe.
Sure. Open it.
I don't think they keep much cash in there.
Open it!
Hardly anything.
There's almost nothing here.
There should be stacks of cash in there. He told us there was. Look again.
There's no stacks. A few dollars in coins. That's it.
Damn! We got a problem. There's a ton of cops out there.
Come on now! We got you surrounded!
That greasy son of a bitch! He set us up!
You think?
This seemed like a good time for sarcasm to you, Arthur.
You gonna do, gentlemen?
Something!
Try not to trust him.
Follow me, gentlemen! Go now!
Is this trying to go to Tahiti?
I hope so. Hold on, fellas.
Hello, man, and you will
look
stop.
Out on the right. We got some in those alleyways, Arthur.
Stand up on that balcony. Some riders coming on this side.
Arthur, cover our left. Left. Ah! Arthur, you need help running now. Look out! Fight! Bronte is gonna pay for this.
Oh, I trust him.
Things broke. Hold on!
Where are we going? I thought you meant to plan this, man. Watching my eagle eye. Oh, there's one up there. I noticed that. I've got my wife a while, so man, and my horse. Ran for it. Fun. Look at a bounty.
I think we're clear.
You know what, Dutch? Next time, it's not damn discretion.
Seemed like a good lead.
I know, but...
Well, we made it. Thanks to you.
Don't miss it.
Yeah. You're a good kid.
And we each got $15. Oh, and a quarter. Don't forget the quarter.
Shut up, Arthur. He set us up.
She's entrusted him.
Like a yokel. Put the law on us. What do we do to him? What did I do to him?
I guess he thinks he's the king around here. He don't want the likes of you. So, What are we doing next, Dutch?
We just need money. One more decent take, and we're gone.
The bank is our bet.
Hosea agrees. Even after that, especially after that. I don't feel so good.
Now you just got a bash on the head.
Come on, I'm taking you back to camp.
Hey, you did real good there, Lenny. Just wish it could have turned out better.
Well, can't win them all.
Well, that was fun. Where's the next mission? I've got time in the video for one more. I'm already halfway up there, so I might as well just... What's that one? No, I'm not doing that one. I can't be bothered. I can't go back to the city yet, so... Let's go there. I'll see you there. I get there, guys. I can't do that for now. Get in here. What was that examined sight thing then? Oh, I can pick mushrooms.
You came.
Of course I came. Said I would.
There's a foreman. His name is Danbury. There's the files in the office above the refinery room. It's that window with the blind drawn up.
I see.
If the files are as incriminating as we believe, Mr. Cornwall's men will destroy them if they know you're coming.
There's only one of me, son. I don't intend for them to know I'm coming. What will the files say?
There'll be a report from Leyland Oil Development Company.
And you got the money?
Yes.
Any ideas how I sneak into this place?
You can crawl under the fence, or hide in a wagon. They keep rolling in.
I'll go take a look.
If there's a problem, call for me.
I thought the whole point was that this had nothing to do with you.
Ideally.
If you are quick, you could climb into the back of that wagon.
I've been here before. Turned to a wagon before. For the train heist.
Hey, you Al?
Hey, Tom?
Picking up?
Yep. Supposed to meet the early train to Saint Denis.
Okay. Better get a move on then.
Does. Oh, I got my bow. Bugger. With a knife. And that. Cleanse your way in. Whoa, don't fall off. Buff for a door, I think. Oops. Someone
there. What was that? Someone there?
Friend, this won't take long. Danbury.
Yes.
I need some papers, my friend. Nothing important. A file from head office.
You're not from head office. You're not from head office.
Does that seem important right now?
No.
Need a file by the Leland Oil Development Company. The one about the oil near Wapiti? Danbury, think, man. Mind is a terrible thing to lose, especially over such a nice floor as this.
It's here! It's here!
You done good, Danbury. Real good. They'll give you a promotion for this.
Yes. All's fine.
Now stay quiet. Our head office will send me back to get you.
Hey, weapons on the ground and hands in the air.
Easy now, fellas.
Now, we won't tell you again.
I got hit for 7 months. I think I'm about to shoot him as well. I'm gonna knock up my rifle. Come on, run.
Some of that oil burn. So you met Mr. Danbury?
Yes, don't worry. He was very obliging. I thought you wasn't getting involved.
Thought you were gonna enter and leave silently.
Thank you. You saved my life.
Thank you. I hope. Well, I don't know what I hope. But who knows? Maybe these will be of some use. Here's your money.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Nice. Well, I think I've got time for one more mission, I think. I'll have a quick look, and I'll just hide from there. So I might do the Dutch one. Hang on, I can do that while I'm here, actually. Right there. I want to do that. So that's all about while I'm here. A lot of these things are a waste of time, but
for a moment. The name's William.
Arthur.
You familiar with the study of plants, my friend?
Familiar ain't quite the word I'd use.
Well, familiar sometimes.
This great earth beneath our feet can provide everything man ever needs. But we've only reached a tiny bit of its potential.
Is there one plant I like?
There are thousands, maybe millions of plants. All across this vast country we share. The mountains, the plains, the swamps. I mean to explore them all. To know all of nature's bounty and all of her wonder, if I can.
Sure.
But I'm only one man. Would you consider helping me with gathering herbs for my studies?
Why?
Knowledge, kindness, beauty.
Well, I'm ignorant, ugly. Nasty.
Well, let's see if maybe we can do something about that.
I'll see.
Okay.
I'm looking for a plant called yarrow. You can distinguish it by its red flowers. It shouldn't be too hard to find. They thrive out in the open under direct sunlight.
Okay. I don't think.
Hey, listen, I can't go collecting for you right now. Good luck, anyway.
Oh, okay then. Some other time, perhaps.
Right. Oh, I can do that while I'm here, though. Nah, that means I'm going back into the city, doesn't it? What's that one there? No, I'm not going there yet. Right, let me have a look at what time I've got. How long the video is, what time I've got. Give me a sec, guys. Yeah, I think I've got time to do that one just near me now. That one where I've got to get that wanted guy. I'll see you when I get there, guys. Won't take me long to get there. A couple minutes. Just around the corner, pretty much. Bit of a fight, I think, but... Keep my horse there a minute. Whoa. What the? How is this place? Oh, I shot the wrong guy. It's annoying because... Come to surrender indicator on the map. I aimed at him, so I kind of thought it was him. Should have left it. Actually, I'll lasso him, actually. It'd be easier if I do that. Oh, come on, that's ridiculous, man. But anyway, guys, I will get through it. I will. What is that?
Strike livestock, Mr. McDaniel? I ain't ever seen the actual impact. I came across the pasture sometime after. The storm had just cleared and there was smoke in the air. Smell of burning hair.
It's gonna take me not too long to get there, like.
No, must have been a dozen head of cattle lying there piled. Up mangled. Strange scars across there. Electricity does something, all right. I seen trees explode in front of me. I seen desert sand baked into glass. That's what I seen lightning do. But, hey, this electricity professor's got a plan for you. Oh, that must be an entirely different kind.
I start crying. How far am I, but I've really got to travel. Yeah, you guys, you may just want to skip forward in the video by like 5 minutes. If you don't want to watch me just walk along here. Walk along here, I mean ride along here. I think the most funniest bit about it is that the way he's crying and the way off is just trolling him. Not far off, but... No, I've got a horse doing it, haven't I?
Easy now.
I'm sorry about that, McDaniels. You all right? Me too. Well, you'll be happy to know we ain't got.
Oh, we're almost there.
Hold on tight now.
He's literally crying. Wimp. Much, how would you react if you was told that? And you didn't know how it was and it hadn't even been admitted yet? You'd be scared. This guy doesn't put any gas on me.
My humane electric ending facilitator. Now, there'll be money enough for you, sir.
Well, let's hope.
Alright, let's get our poor unfortunate ready for the demonstration. Oh, do come and watch. It'll be amazing.
I have to watch it as well. Oh my god. Going all for not yet. Okay. There he is. I think that's it for today, guys. I hope you enjoyed today's video. If you have, please click on the notification bell to stay up to date with all more content. And once again, if there's any gameplays, walkthroughs you want to see, let me know and comment below and I'll get them done for you. Take care, guys. Peace out.